In this example, the solution we want to now create use a stacked bar. If you look at the data, you'll see it's a little bit different in the sense that the first one is exactly the same. You'll see it's 1st of June. But from then, can you see that it goes 10th of Jan, 00. And that's because a stacked will actually do all this adding for you. So if I converted this to a number, what you'll see is the first one is a date in Excel format. And the others, even though they are formatted as dates, they are just numbers. Let's just undo it. So now let's set up a stacked bar. So I'm going to say insert. And now instead of a cluster, we're going to have a stacked bar. Switch it on. So you'll see now we've got the stacked bar set up. Again, we still want to start on the 1st of June. So I'm going to right click here, format axes, and the number we're going to use is this 42522. So you'll see that's already looking pretty accurate. We can now go through and just set up the labels. So I'm going to right click here, put data labels, and just change it, for example, to be the series name. So we've got a setup. We can then again decide where we want to put it, but it's quite nice in the center. And so it's just a case of going through all of this and repeating the process to get to the answer you want. Eventually, when you have the labels on, you may want to tweak this. If you want it at all, we can maybe remove that and remove this, and you're left with a Gantt chart that shows what needs to be done at what time frames.